Most of my work deals with how to make metals and processing metals. Typically, when we make metals, we start with liquid metal at very high temperatures. And there's many different chemical reactions and transformations that occur during that high temperature processing. And so most of my research focuses on that. We work all the way from 250 tons of liquid metal to very, very small scale, nanometer scale precipitates in metal. How do we use chemical reactions to make metal cleaner or improve the properties of metal? So my work tries to influence how we do industrial processing. In particular, I have one project where we're working with the steel industry on making new steels, particularly for automotive applications. Steel is a very common material for automotive construction because it has a wide range of properties. This lets automotive designers do things like maximize passenger safety and fuel economy. One way that we influence the property of steel is by changing its chemical composition, and there are many new steels that are being developed for advanced automotive applications. The specific project that I'm working on deals with processing of these steels and the reactions and transformations that occur during cooling. We're trying to solve a problem of cracking of these steels during processing. By studying these reactions and transformations, we're hoping to enable the steel industry to produce these steels at higher volume and supply the automotive industry. Metals are very important engineering materials. We use them in many, many applications. And there's many different strategies for how we take and process metals to get them into some useful form. And there's lots of interesting research questions as we go forward, in particular, with how are we going to best produce metals for applications in the real world.